Hey everybody, it's 40ware. Welcome back to Mass Effect 2. We are nearing the end, as you can see, because last time, the collectors attacked us, and the Illusive Man got word of it. He said this is a slap in the face from the collectors, and a sign that we've got them scared. Ooh. Lost of the crew is devastating, but remember they signed on knowing the risk. Miranda's already argued delaying stuff, but we're fully prepared already, so we don't have to worry about that. Get it done, Shepard. Nobody else can. I don't feel like doing a Larry Cable Guy Geeter done thing. So, let's go. And remember you gotta switch the game discs if you're playing on the Xbox, because I always forget this. I just remembered today, really, that the Omega 4 relay goes back to the first disc for whatever whack job reason. And alright, go figure. So anyway, the Omega 4 relay. Surrounded by hazard beacons and automated warnings, over the last 1,000 years, many have attempted, none have come back. Many will enter, no one will win. Sounds like a great slogan for a lottery, doesn't it? So yeah.
Please confirm destination, Shepard. The Reaper IFF is online, but there is a chance that the Normandy may not survive the Omega 4 relay. Once we are en route, we are committed.
Since when was this such a big issue?
The collectors are about to find out what happens when you piss me off.
You got it, Commander. Plotting a course for the Omega 4 relay. ETA about 2 hours. I'll let you know when we arrive.
So what if you're about 10 minutes on the way there and you said, oh, wait a minute, we hit something. Or one of the engines is being a bit of a pain. What do you do? You can't just go, oh, we gotta keep forging forward. I mean, seriously, we are lottery. We can't do shit. Since when was that such a big issue? I'm sure spaceships have dealt with that many times in the past. So why is it such a big issue now? I mean, if you ever watch Star Trek, you know when the dilithium crystals go, they have to stall or slow down, assess damage, and see what the hell is going on before doing anything. You act. And oh yes, this.
So
completely forgot about this.
I've
for
taken
some dumb reason.
Antibiotics as well as some herbal supplements that should bolster my immune system. I was going to bring music, but I didn't know what you'd like. And I'm babbling like an idiot.
Tally, why you stop acting so cute? Jeez.
It's okay. Come here.
I just don't want to. I want this to work. I thought it over. I've minimized the risks, but I'm still nervous, and that always makes me talk too much. It's a defense mechanism, and it's stupid, and people who just see the helmet can't see my expression, so I have to make it clear what I'm feeling.
I'm pretty sure it didn't take a rocket scientist to figure out what she was feeling behind the mask at that time. I'm pretty sure of it. Anywho, one last final pep talk from Martin Sheen here, and we'll be on our way. Actually, Smashware 182
Shepard,
told me a couple days ago that
I don't like you heading through that really.
He compared the Elusive Man to Mitt Romney and the faces, and oh my god, it's a lot more accurate than I thought. The similarities are. I was shocked when I heard that, because I know they superimposed Martin Sheen's character in, or his face in. But, like, when he told me to look at Mitt Romney's and then look at the Elusive Man, holy shit. Almost scary.
I'm not going alone. I've got some of the best working with me. If we stick together, we'll make it.
I knew we brought you back for a reason. I've never seen a better leader. Despite the danger, it's a great opportunity. The first human to take a ship through and survive.
I've got room on the Normandy if you're that eager to see it.
It's a tempting offer, but it's not my place. I just wanted you to know I appreciate the risk you're taking. Regardless of your opinion of Cerberus, of me, you are a valuable asset to all of humanity. Be careful, Shepard.
Don't you feel inspired by Marge Sheen yet? Are you not entertained? Now, Martin Sheen did an excellent job with the Elusive Man, without question. I think everybody praised his performance as the Elusive Man in the second game, and in the third game as well, since he did come back.
Reaper IFF activated.
At least they didn't get Charlie Sheen, because then we would have been talking about to a guy that thinks he's from Mars and takes the drug known as Charlie Sheen and is constantly concerned with winning. Among other things. Hopefully I got all the ship upgrades, otherwise I would be in for a very rude surprise.
Too close.
It's like Fallout 3 in space. I think I just created the new Fallout game. Fallout in space!
The Omega 4 relay. Some look ancient.
I have detected an energy signature near the edge of the accretion disk.
Has to be the collector base. Take us in for a closer look. Nice and easy.
Careful, Jeff. We have company.
Taking evasive maneuvers.
Ah, yes. Those things.
You're just pissing me off. Take these characters out.
As long as the new plating holds.
You want another round? Come on, girl, let's give it to him.
So as you imagine, Miranda made a reference already to the new armor plating, which means if you didn't get that, somebody would die. For every ship upgrade you don't have, someone will die. And it's a very silly way to lose somebody, so quite frankly, that's probably the unless you're actually trying, there's no excuse really to have that happen. So anyway, something got in, so what you're going to want to do is bring your anti-armor people. And my anti-armor people involve probably anybody that knows warp. And maybe if I brought a specialized ammo person. Wait, did I bring Zaid at all? I forget if I showed off heavy inferno grenade or not. Let me see if it actually works on this. I've never tried this before. Okay, the one... You're gonna want to bring a good heavy weapon, unless you have the Widow. The Widow will negate that, effectively. And the first Oculus is not the one to worry about. Worry about the second. You can try attacking this Oculus, and you kind of should, but it's not that big a deal, because you're going to get another round with this sucker. But this is why I like the Widow, because the Widow does a lot of damage. It's already causing immense pain. You just gotta be alert, because if he overbears on you like that, then you're kind of in trouble. That thing doesn't seem to be too effective. This guy's not very hard at all. If you have, because you should always have at least one thing that'll take care of an Oculus, whether it's a power like Incinerate or a Warp, or just using guns.
We're sitting ducks out here. I have to try to lose them in the
debris. I think it's only limited to when you do enough damage to that sucker, but I'm not sure. I know the first Oculus you probably won't be able to kill.
Well, I guess it's a good thing we upgraded. We're going in.
Actually, when I was playing this the first time, I won't say my heart was palpitating, but I was kind of like, oh my god, what's gonna happen?
Kinetic barrier steady at 30%. No significant damage.
Looking back on it, I was really, really stupid to get so excited over that, especially after I upgraded.
An enemy heading for the cargo hold.
That thing again. This one's up to Shepard.
No problem there. So now you have a little tougher battle, because now you're over here. Remember, the red spot is the weakness. Just like in any real enemy, if you hit the red thing, you will do damage. The toughest part is actually trying to avoid getting to cover with this thing around. And I think he notices you despite the cloak, which makes him a little tougher. I need some ammo, badly. Anybody got ammo? Let me hear some. That did some damage. Yeah, that thing's in bad shape now. Ooh, I do have 200, nuke. That's gonna help me out.
Change weapon. We need to...
No, all you need is the right weapons. It's not what you know, it's who you know. Or in this case, die, bitch. I would definitely not recommend using the cane against that thing. It's a waste of ammo. Trust me on that. I've never had 200 cane ammo before.
There it is.
At least it gives me a backup shot for when I need it. In case I somehow F up the first cane.
See if you can find a place to land without drawing attention.
Too late. Looks like they're sending out an old friend to greet us.
Oh boy. I'm sure you remember this ship. Complete with the cliche ominous music. Well, you notice that attack took forever, it seemed like, for the gun to actually hit the collector ship. Why didn't the collector ship move? That might have actually helped its causes. Not that I'm complaining, but it just seemed like that first attack took forever. It was like slowly coming at the ship, and the ship did absolutely, well, nothing. Absolutely no sense.
Mass effect field generators are
are offline. Edie, give me something.
Generator's unresponsive. All engines for impact.
Joker, you okay?
I think I broke a rib. Or all of them.
Multiple core systems overloaded during the crash. Restoring operation will take time.
We all knew this was likely a one-way trip.
I'll do whatever it takes to stop the collectors, but I plan to live to tell about it.
I'm glad you're in charge. What's next?
How long until the collectors find this landing zone?
I do not detect an internal security network. It is possible the collectors did not expect anyone to reach the base.
Well, if we're lucky, their external sensors were hit like we were. They might not know we're alive.
This is it. The final mission. Who will survive? Oh, who am I kidding? I can't do a movie trailer or epic PA announcer voice. It's just not in me. Because it sounds, in a world where... Yeah. Not very effective at all. Epic? No. Skilled? No. Absolutely nothing.
This isn't how we planned this mission, but this is where we're at. We can't worry about whether the Normandy can get us home. We came to stop the collectors, and that means coming up with a plan to take out this station. Edie, bring up your scans.
You should be able to overload their critical systems if you get to the main control center here.
That means going through the heart of the station, right past this massive energy signature.
That's the central chamber. If our crew or any of the colonists are still alive, the collectors are probably holding them in there.
Looks like there are two main routes. Might be a good idea to split up to keep the collectors off balance, then regroup in the central chamber.
No good. Both routes are blocked. See these doors? The only way past is to get someone to open them from the other side.
It's not a fortress. There's got to be something. Here, maybe we can send someone in through this ventilation shaft.
Practically a suicide mission. I volunteer.
I appreciate the thought, Jacob, but you couldn't shut down the security systems in time. We need to send a tech expert.
It's your call, Commander. Who do we send into the shaft?
Well, after that little stirring disapproval from Miranda, you can still send it, Jacob. So anyway, this is your specialist here. There are only three people that are capable of doing this, and those are the ones that you would figure have the best tech. So that would be Tally, Kasumi, and Legion. Jacob and Garrus and Thane and Warren, if you bring them, they will die. So don't do it. I bring Tally.
Or put Tally in it. We need someone with tech skills to hack that security system. Tally, you're up.
I won't let you down.
The rest of us will break into two teams and fight down each passage. That should draw the collector's attention away from what you're doing.
I'll lead the second fire team, Shepard. We'll meet up with you on the other side of the doors.
Not so fast, cheerleader. Nobody wants to take orders from you.
This isn't a popularity contest. Lives are at stake. Shepard, you need someone who can command loyalty through experience.
Despite Jack's objections, because Jack, you can't take seriously, just shut the hell up. Miranda is an option. If you don't, Garrus is also an option, and Jacob is an option. Zaid, I don't think is. And I'm pretty sure if you send the wrong person, the tech specialist is the one that eats it. So, yeah. This first part, send Garrus. I always send Garrus.
You're in charge of the second team.
I always send Garrus to the first one.
Well,
because at least he gets his chance to lead another team and not have to deal with any of the betrayal crap.
Once we're in, they're gonna throw everything they have at us. If we're weak, if we're slow, if we hesitate, we'll die. The collectors attacked our ship. They took our crew. our friends.
Anybody find the Renegade actions kind of odd? Because you're standing there with Shepard, just stand there nonchalantly while you pick a decision. All of a sudden,
we're here to make them regret.
After about 5 seconds, he goes, "The collector's commanded our crew." Slammed the desk for no reason. I've always found that little time delay kind of funny.
Let's hit them where they live.
So yeah. I should have everything set up for the final charge. This first part's gonna be interesting, because I've never really failed it ever. I was close once. I was playing on Insanity for the first time, and I almost lost the tech specialist around, like, the 6th valve or something. So, you're gonna be facing nothing but collectors for the whole thing, as you'd imagine. Well, the whole first part. I mean, it's all the collector enemies, including husks and the like. The first part, there are no husks, so I'm going to send Grunt out with me and go with Zaid. Because that'll destroy barriers, that'll destroy armor, and that'll keep me set. Yeah, I'm going to keep the cane. I think. Is I want to save the cane for the absolute final part. Let's go.
I'm inside the ventilation shaft, Shepard. It's hot in here, but it's clear as far as I can tell.
Second team, are you in position?
Let's roll.
In position. Meet you on the other side of those doors.
So here's our first meeting. As you see, it's just your basic token collector drones. These guys are worthless. Just be aware, I think Harbinger will show up at some point, so. No problem there.
Reinforcements are coming in.
They're coming out of the woodwork. Oh no! Not reinforcements, no! Wait, why haven't I given myself the squad incendiary ammo yet? Jeez, dude. You forget what you're doing? Oh wow. So, the final fight themes are pretty good. I do like the I do think the suicide mission theme is one of the best in the game. But the fight theme doesn't really stand out to me that much. So much for that challenge. You shouldn't die there at all. It's a very easy. It's that part is actually really, really easy. And this will start the race. 7 valves, and you gotta try to get there while fighting collectors, obviously. And Harbinger! As well. Yep, as you see, when the specialist is danger, you have a limited amount of time before you can actually do anything. If not, well, the specialist dies, and yeah, you're back to the drawing board. I've never had that happen before, though. So it's just basically a non-stop race to the end, where you're just fighting collectors and just hoping. They probably would have actually done better if they actually sent their whole squad after me at once. But nope, that's not the way they think.
I'll put them down.
Forces of the universe bend.
I don't care what you think, Harbinger. You're gonna die.
Looks like another one of those
wait a minute. He's already gone. The first valves aren't too bad, it's the last few that are ridiculous. The last three I remember are pretty tough. Like, look at that one. That one's a miserable excuse for one. But now it's gonna get interesting.
You're hitting me, Shepard!
Well, get out of the way! Run, I have a clear shot, I want it. Yeah, you see that Inferno Grade's actually not that bad. Oh wow, I didn't actually see the rest of the clutches there, I thought they were all dead. Oh, not again, Harbinger, come on, really? Fine, I'll take out the time waster known as Harbinger. That Inferno Grenade really, really is helpful in that situation. It's also a great cover buster. That's the one thing about it I really like. Oh god. In a case like this, I'll just basically ignore the ignore Harbinger for the time being and actually make a mad dash if need be. It's not foolhardy as much as it seems. In fact, it actually is very, very probably the best option you have, because Harbinger, generally speaking, is slow. And having cloak also helps matters. Yeah, that's how you gotcha. Okay, good. Yeah, that is not something I don't think I wanted to have happen. Beating Harbinger up close and personal. Shepard, move up the... Why doesn't Shepard just move up the steps when I ask him to? Jeez, everything's gotta be such a damn adventure. All right, the last two. I wonder if I get extra points for using a fire-based attack with things that look like bugs. Because honestly, they do look like bugs. Demented bugs.
I'll put them down.
Okay, I got it. Now for the final one, I don't think you need to destroy everybody. They're gonna send the house, obviously, but I think if I'm an infiltrator, I should be able to cut through no problem. But I think you still have to... I'm not sure if you still have to fight them or not. That's the thing. The fact that it's uphill also doesn't help matters. Oh, goddammit. That'll help me. Thank goodness for Reeve. Goddammit! I got greedy. Bump it up, bump, bump, bump. I was waiting for that. Okay. Hopefully this works. That's all I had to do? That's all I had to do. Are you kidding me? Okay. That's all I had to do.
I knew you wouldn't let me down.
Shepard, you need to see this.
So So the first part done. And Miranda found something really, really grisly. I'm sure you remember the pods, right? Well, yeah.
Looks like one of the missing colonists.
There's more over here.
And they're not dead.
God. She's still alive.
Oh shit. They're being creepified. Ooh. Yeah, if that doesn't fill up your WTF, nothing will. Now, if I didn't go for the crew immediately after, they would all have been husked, so. I don't think they would have attacked you, but they would have been dead. Let's put it that way.
You came for us.
No one gets left behind.
Thank God you got here in time. A few more seconds and I don't even want to think about it.
The colonists were processed. Those swarms of little robots, they melted their bodies into gray liquid and pumped it through these tubes.
Why are they doing this? What are they doing with our genetic material?
I don't know. I'm just glad you got here before it happened to us.
So are we. But we still have a job to do. We've done well so far. Let's hope we can finish the job.
Joker, can you get a fix on our position?
Roger that, Commander. All those tubes lead into the main control room right above you. The route is blocked by a security door, but there's another chamber that runs parallel to the one you're in.
I cannot recommend that. Thermal emissions suggest the chamber is overrun with seeker swarms. Morden's countermeasure cannot protect you against so many at once.
What about biotics? Could we create a biotic field to keep them from getting near us?
Yes, I think it may be possible. I wouldn't be able to protect everyone, but we might be able to get a small team through if they stayed close.
I could do it too. In theory, any biotic could handle it. Shepard, who do you want to maintain the field?
I'm gonna stop it here and I'll answer this the next time. So see you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.